So this is part two of Webex video conferencing software tutorials. And in this video, I'm going to show you three very important things. First, we'll talk about your personal video conference room and what are three addresses which you have in your personal room when you open a Webex account. Then we will talk about the whiteboard feature in Webex. What are various features you have in the whiteboard? And I will also show you one of my tablets, which I use to write on whiteboards, in particular when I have to write a lot. And then the third part is that we will discuss some of the privileges which you can assign or you can allow your participants during a video conference. There are many features which you can allow your participants during the video conference, or you do not allow them. So we will discuss where are those features and how you can use them. I will also show you how you can save your whiteboard in a PDF document. And we are starting right after a short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. If this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. Now, when you get an account with the Webex, you get a personal room. And there are three addresses associated with your personal room. And this you should understand. One address is a URL address or a web address, which is here, which is also called personal room link. Then the second address is a call-in phone number. And you can call this number in order to join any meeting in your personal room. And if you do that, then you have to use a host PIN, which is here, and you must keep this PIN private, as I mentioned earlier. Then there is also a third address, which is normally overlooked, and that is called video address. Technically speaking, video address is also called URI address, or Uniform Resource Identifier. So these are three different addresses of your personal room, which you must understand and know all the times. So before I start explaining Webex Whiteboard, I would like to show you my tablet. This is a Wacom tablet, a WSUM. This is a cheap tablet you can buy in maybe $150. And the benefit is that it's very easy to write using this tablet on the whiteboard. You just write normal as you would write on a paper, and this will be printed on your Webex whiteboard. Otherwise, writing with mouse is very difficult and it needs a lot of practice. So therefore, I would highly recommend that you get this tablet. It has a cable and a pen. This is the pen which comes with the tablet, and it has a cable attached to it. And the other end of this cable is a USB connector, which we put in any of the port on our PC. And then you simply write on this. Now let's talk about whiteboard features in Webex. Now I have started a meeting, and to access a whiteboard, I click the third icon from the left at the bottom, which says share content. And now at the very end, I have this new whiteboard option. If I click on that, I will get this message how the contents will be shared, and I click OK, because the purpose of this video is to show you the features of the whiteboard. And now let us first talk about writing. So first we choose the color of the pen. So I click on that and I choose blue. And now I click on this pencil icon, and I can select either a pen or a pencil. So let us click on pen. And now I can write on this. And let us say I change it to pencil now. And if I write now, it will be a little thinner. Now if I want to draw a line, I can click on this line icon. And then I can draw a line in any way. I can also draw shapes by clicking on this shape icon. And we have four shapes available: a rectangle, then we have an oval shape, also we have a tick sign, and now a tick will be drawn wherever I click. Then we have a cross sign, and if I click now, a cross will be drawn. Now at the top we have this arrow, and there are two options in it. One is the arrow pointer and the other is laser pointer. And if I click on arrow pointer, now I can draw arrow pointer wherever I want to highlight something. So in this way, I can emphasize on any particular area of my presentation. And as you can see that my name is written here. So if we are collaborating with other participants, they can also collectively point various parts of a presentation on a whiteboard. And now let's click on laser pointer. It is a little bit different because sometimes your mouse pointer is not very visible to other participants. So you can use this laser pointer. And you have the ability to scroll down. So on the right hand side, if I scroll down, I have area available where I can further write. Then in this eraser option, we have four options. Clear my pointer, clear all pointers, clear my annotations, and clear all annotations. So pointers means these arrows. And then at the end, we have the option to save this whiteboard. And we can save this in a UCF format, which is the Universal Communication Format by Cisco. And purpose of this format is that you have the ability to share rich media contents, audio, video files, or your PowerPoint presentations and your Excel files, for example. But in order to be able to see those files, the participant must have the application. For example, if you are sharing a video file, other participant must have a video player to watch that file. But in this case, I'm going to select the PDF format. And I select this format, and then I select desktop where I want to save this file, and I simply click save. And now let me open this file if I click on this PDF. As you can see that all our whiteboard presentation is saved in a PDF format. So this is very good. For example, if you are taking a class, your students can get this PDF as a future reference. And the last thing is this text. If I click on this text, I can click anywhere and I can add some text here. And one thing you should note is that the last used feature is displayed here. So I used the laser pointer. So that is displayed here. I use the cross mark, which is displaying here. So don't get confused with these icons. Now, on the left hand side, you also have this menu where you can see the pages. Currently, I am on page 1. You can also zoom in to your whiteboard if you want, or zoom out, or you can click this to fit to width. So if I click this, all your whiteboard will be in the screen. You can also get a thumbnail view here. So if I click here, you can see how many pages you have. And to go back to full screen, you simply click on that icon again. Now here you have meeting information. So these were the features of Webex Whiteboard. Hopefully I have covered all of them. If not, you can put in the comments and we can discuss further. Now let us talk about participant privileges. So there are three places where you can set various options, and I'm going to discuss those. The first point is in the participant tabs, we have assigned privileges. And here you can set the communication privileges, how participants can chat privately or publicly. So there are two areas here. You can allow them to chat privately with host, with the presenter, and with other participants, or you can allow them to publicly chat with everyone. Then in the participant tab, there are some more privileges which you can assign to your meeting participants. So it is important to check this area so that whatever you want to assign, you can do here, or whatever you want to uncheck. Now the second place is in meeting options. And here are three important meeting options, which also affect the way you want to allow certain things to your participants. And the third place, so let me close these two. And the third place is in edit and preferences. And here you can set some sound options for chat and also for participants. So if you click on participant tabs, now you have the ability to select a few of the sound variations on certain actions. For example, if someone joins the meeting, so which sound you want to have? So there are few options available. So if I click this, I can actually click on this arrow and I can listen the sound. And if I like that, I can select this sound. Otherwise, I have some other options. Similarly, if someone leaves the meeting, what kind of sound you want to have? And the most important option is raise hand. So raise hand option is very important when, for example, you are teaching online and you want to make sure that your students are watching you They are there in front of their devices. So you can throw a question and ask them to raise hands. And the most common use of this feature is to allow your participants to ask questions during a video presentation. And you can also select a particular sound for this so that you understand that someone has raised hand. So these were three places where you can set participant privileges and various options for your video conferencing on Webex. So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching and see you next time.